XP, do you have any cobblestone?
Cobblestone? No. Go sell a fish.
Oh, dang it. All right.
Hey, weren't we supposed to be doing something around this time?
I don't know. Where are we?
Honestly, we haven't been doing a whole lot this month.
Oh, wait. That's what we were supposed to be doing. It's time for the monthly episode of the CDNN. It's the end of October, which means it's time for a month update on what's been happening on Dogcraft.
Unfortunately, all of the cool, spooky things happen at the end of the month, after our recording.
But that doesn't mean some cool things haven't happened. For example, our summer build contest winners were announced.
To catch you up on the details, back in August, Dogcraft had a summer 2024 sandcastle build competition. Contestants could build pretty much whatever they wanted, but they had to use items one would normally find on the beach.
Randall Robb took third place. Kierkit and Fraser tied for second place, and our winner for the competition was Elasmotherium.
Congratulations to all of the participants. That's not the only build thing to have popped up over the month, certainly.
No. There seems to be a... well, it's certainly something. Roll the tape.
Take it away, Nick!
Hey, Mega Chippy! Binley Mega Chippy! Binley Mega Chippy! Binley Mega Chippy!
Is this thing on? Hello! Yep, okay, hi everybody! My name is Montanator. Yes, you thought the Binley Mega Chippy meme was 6 feet under in the grave 2 years ago, but hey ho, I'm late to the party. Here we go! Binley Mega Chippy, a retriever spawn, just what the whole server was asking for, and you know what? People are loving it right now. We have had over 20 reviews, averaging 2.5 stars. I'm so proud of the business venture. Everybody was over here. Unfortunately, our employee ZTs, you know, bit of a problem, flooded the entire place, but hey, we got some fresh fish in there. It's raining now. That's no good. Point being, we have a van parked outside. Kemi, he says he's banned to the bone. He's not, because he's not paid his parking fee. 1300 DCD. I need it now, Kemi. You better pay up. Regardless, here we go. Binley Mega Chippy, Retriever Spawn. So if you've got nothing better to do, come on down to the Binley Mega Chippy, the freshest fish around, because they're literally still swimming inside. I've been Montanator. This has been my newest business venture. Everyone needs to see this place. It's the best place on Dogcraft. If I would suggest a defining moment for Survival 6, it's obviously the Binley Mega Chippy. Nothing compares. I know that. We all know that. So why not come down and see a piece of history for yourself before the health inspectors destroy it? I've been Montanator. This is the Binley Mega Chippy. You're welcome.
Goodness, that was... Well, I could go for some chips, I suppose.
I think I have somewhere else to be that isn't there.
What do you mean? What could possibly be better than the Binley Mega Chippy?
Well, the Canine Kingdom had a cool event take place.
Ooh, do we have a fantastically edited video made by our spectacular bookworm?
We do.
Well, I've got to see that.
Aw, come on, guys.
All right, so for this next segment, we are back here in Canine Kingdom looking at a brand new game, which has been designed by Vibeing. This is a play on Rendog's Scoot Ball from Hermitcraft, and this is Cyber Ball. So we're very lucky to be joined by B here in the Cyber Ball Arena here. So do you want to tell us a bit about the game, B?
This is Cyber Ball. Obviously, with Scoot Ball, Rin's version, they use an armadillo as the ball, but we don't have armadillos. So next best option, we decide to use a player. So for the game, we have two teams. We'll try and score a goal by knockback sword bonking a player into the goal.
And it's very safe, right, for the player that is the ball. They've got full netherite armor, so there's no chance of them dying, right?
Full netherite, as well as protection 4, and then we've got the beacons in the corners, which they've got the resistance 2 on them. So nice and safe, don't take any damage. The players, however, may take a little bit of damage because there is some team-on-team violence occurring.
Yeah, it gets quite intense, some of these games, yeah. So how long have you been working on this game?
Oh gosh, probably most of a month. My favorite hid like Easter egg is a couple of hamsters.
Oh,
the longest thing, honestly, 1, 2, 3, 4 gold beacons.
Oh yeah, yeah, I can imagine that's a lot of gold blocks. So we had a few games earlier today, and they were fantastic. Let's roll some footage of that now.
Right, everyone ready?
Yes.
Ready.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, go.
Goodness, this is.
Oh no.
I'm running away.
That's a goal. 3, 2, 1, go.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. There we go. That's how it.
Oh, that's an out.
You got it, X?
Oh, hang on. That's an out. So the way I thought we'd manage this is that so the ball can move, obviously, to get like back to the edge. And then defending team gets the kickoff.
Oh! No, wrong way! Oh, that was me! There we go.
And that's a goal. 3, 2, 1, go. Oop. Out.
Oh no! XP, you got it! No, XP!
I got it. Yes. Oh, that was a good play, Sam. Good pass.
3, 2, 1, go.
So just as a question, are we allowed to hit the other teams?
I think so. Okay, it can be a strategy. Oh, there's an out.
Okay, you're out.
They were still quick.
Oh, they're getting me! Oh my goodness!
Oh, and that's a lie.
That was real close.
Also, I see like. Oh. I think I see like benefit in hitting your own teammate forward if you're like really far from the ball.
Five, four, three, two, one, go.
Get out.
Back to you, HP.
Look at this.
Do you have a fishing rod to put the ball back in the middle? Yeah, okay.
I actually do have that one.
I was writing the score down.
This is almost slightly better than the other version of Scootball, because it's an actual player. You know, you don't have to worry about getting the ball back into position.
Yeah.
All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. And out. Nice save.
That's in.
3, 2, 1, go.
This reminds me of the start of Rocket League when everybody just rushes into the ball.
Nope, nice. That was on the line.
That was on the line, yeah. Oh! No!
Get out! Come on! Dang it!
Wait, which one's Sam?
It's surprisingly hard to figure out which one is Sam.
I went with the gold for the ball, because I was like, I feel like that's the brightest contrast against, like, the other colors. Oh.
That was a good Nathan's move.
Okay, that was 3 points for blue.
You guys ready?
Ready to go.
Yep, ready.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go.
Don't slide out, don't slide out. That's not cool.
Oh, God! Oh, damn. No!
No. No, Ed, that's not cool. Going on a run. Only I can do that.
Oh, go on, Kevin!
That's a goal! That's a goal!
Nice work, Orange.
3, 2, 1, go.
Oh, we're getting closer. Yes! Let's go. Let's go.
Oh, that's
not that kind of saved you.
I don't want to say anything, blue team, but all the spectators are on the orange stands.
Look, the people know.
Well, I played for Orange. So.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go.
Uh-oh.
That's a good old shot. Let's go.
Oh, right over the bar, oh my goodness.
That's a massive out of bounds.
That's good.
I think it's definitely a good idea to not all engage all three of them at the same time.
Mm-hmm. He's going. Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That's it?
Yeah.
Well done.
Clean sweep.
That was a quick game.
Yeah, some really fun games there. This was a great game to play. So I guess the last question for us today would be, what are your future plans for the game? Is there any additions you want to add, or are there any plans for future tournaments or something?
I definitely think that there is potential for a tournament style sort of thing going on here. Also, definitely to make a few amendments to the rules, probably mostly to the kickoff stuff, and maybe expand the stands a bit, because, you know, if we're doing tournaments, people might want to come watch.
It seems quite popular today as well. Lots of spectators there. It was great to see. Brilliant. Yeah. Is there any last words you want to say, B?
Thank you to Ren for the initial idea, because this has been a lot of fun to play.
Oh, yeah, certainly. It has been great fun. Really good stuff. Well, thanks so much, B, for joining us on the CDNN today. It was great to see all about the game. Really fun time. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having me.
Man, that sure looks like a lot of fun. If anyone is wondering how they can get in on the action and possibly show up for a CDNN episode, be sure to check out the CyberDog Games Discord. You can find a link under the Community Discord's forum.
On October 26th, Tiger posted about a Halloween event that will be taking place here at the end of the month. There's going to be trick-or-treating, a spooky maze, and more, but the details will be announced very soon. There's also a Halloween costume contest happening, which I for sure will be submitting for. Take a look at the link on screen or in the Discord if you would like to participate. Good luck to all of us, and thanks to Tiger, KFR, and the rest of the creative team who worked diligently on the event.
I think I'm ready to go celebrate the holiday now.
I've got to make some people buy some chips. Buy some chips myself.
I've got to see if anyone understands my costume reference.
Happy Halloween, everyone. Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.